Tony. Welcome to Fill in the Food. Today, I've got a really simple and quick dish. It is getting hot outside. It's the summertime. And so there's tons of stuff available at the farmer's market. I was walking to the grocery store the other day, a very fancy, bougie grocery store. And in their seafood department, they had a sign for sustainably raised local Bay scallops. Now I'm here in California, so I thought that was interesting. And I wanted to check them out. If you know me, you know I'm a bit of a scallop snob. I grew up in Maine, where I think the best sea scallops come from, and I spent three seasons out on Nantucket. Nantucket Bay scallops are the greatest scallop you could ever eat. So I was interested to try these local, and by local I think they probably mean Northern California, Bay scallops. And so these are absolutely delicious. You can do this recipe with any type of fish. I'm gonna teach you a basic crudo slash ceviche technique today. And so you can do this with sea scallops that you dice up, or you can do it with Bay scallops, that would be fine. I would avoid any scallop that is what is called wet pack, which means it's been soaked in a chemical called sodium tripolyphosphate. Sodium tripolyphosphate makes scallops swell and absorb water, and so they weigh more, and so you pay more, but then when you cook them or you eat them, they just don't taste great. And so I'd avoid any wet pack scallops. Obviously, you also want to try to get your scallops fresh, never frozen. And make sure you tell your fishmonger that you're eating them raw or for ceviche. And they'll make sure that you get the freshest available, I hope. Make sure you're buying your seafood at a great place to get food, because you don't want to get sick. Anyway, we're going to make a quick crudo today. You could do this ceviche style. The difference between crudo and ceviche, crudo is meant to be eaten kind of immediately after just a really quick marinade. Everything is still basically raw. Ceviche has been marinated. It implies that it's kind of cooked from the acid in the dish. And so if you want this to be a little bit more cooked, then let it sit overnight or at least for 4 hours. But if you're anything like me, you're not gonna be able to resist. And so I'm gonna eat this. And the way I love to eat scallops the most is basically raw. All right, so I've got my ingredients gathered. Let's start by talking about our scallops. These Bay scallops are really looking amazing. They're plump and they're firm and they don't have any type of smell to them. I have given them a quick rinse and patted them dry with paper towel. Now, when I worked out on Nantucket, we did Bay scallop crudo. We would spend hours picking the side muscle off of these little guys. And oftentimes with sea scallops, I'll pick that off. But when it comes to Bay scallops, I'll admit I'm a little bit lazy, especially if I'm eating them raw. They're not particularly egregious. And so I leave them on. Now to my Bay scallops here, what I'm gonna add is some various garnish. And you can switch this up. I've got some veggie I picked up at the farmer's market, but there are a lot of different ways to do that. I'm gonna start today with a little bit of zucchini. This is a patty pan, squash, zucchini type thing. I love raw zucchini in crudos like this. I love the texture, they're just fresh and light, and they kind of help stretch the volume. I should note, I've got about a half pound of Bay scallops, and that's gonna be enough for me. And I'm gonna eat this for lunch. I'm just gonna have a big bowl of ceviche with tortilla chips, body by tortilla chips here. And so I'm gonna be doing that. I would do a pound of scallops, and then if you're serving it as an appetizer for every three or four people. Okay, back to the zucchini. I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna dice some down. I don't need a whole lot. I'm just gonna slice this, maybe, I don't know, I'm gonna use about half of that, a couple of ounces here of the squash. And I'm just gonna make a small dice. So into wide flats, then into strips, and then right across for a nice small dice. If you have one of those peelers that has a little julienne attachment, let it rip. That works fine as well. Doesn't have to be perfect. Nothing has to be perfect. Nothing at all ever has to be perfect. And so, there are no food police. They're not coming to arrest you. Okay, I'm gonna add a little bit of raw shallot into this. I don't love raw white onion or raw red onion, but for some reason, raw shallot is okay. But I'm gonna add very little, and it's gonna be cut very, very small. What in French classical cuisine would be called a brunoisette, a 16th inch by a 16th inch. How do I make that happen? Very simple. I start by taking my shallot and making some horizontal slices, ideally only about a 16th of an inch from one another horizontally. I'm leaving the back end of my shallot intact here. Then I make some, well, I released out the back, that's okay. I'm gonna then take some vertical slices, again, leaving that back end open. And if it starts to fall apart a little bit, not the end of the world, don't freak out, it's gonna be okay. I pull it all together and come right across. Okay, my diced shallot goes right in. And this is probably a couple tablespoons. I used half of one big shallot. So you don't need to add a whole lot. Clean up my cutting board here. Okay, let's add a little bit of jalapeno. I'm gonna do about half of this large jalapeno. And again, I'm gonna dice it quite small. Probably not half. I start by having it lengthwise. And I'm gonna cut this into a quarter lengthwise. I'm gonna start with a quarter of this. And I'm just using bare hands today. If you wanna be careful you don't get spicy eyes or spicy other bits at some point in the day, then you can certainly wear gloves. I'm gonna wash my hands a ton. And then, you know, it's always a little bit like roulette. I remember that I was working with jalapenos early in the day later. I removed that seed bed, and this doesn't have a ton of seeds. That is where a lot of the heat relies and kind of stays. And so by removing that, I remove a lot of the heat here. And I'm just gonna cut this as thin as possible. Same technique, long strips and then right across. Now, I wanted a little bit of avocado. I was camping this weekend down in the Central Coast, and there was a great little farm stand next to the private property that we camped on. And they had a little avocado farm. They had a little farm stand where they were selling avocados, so we picked a couple up. And so, these look delicious. Again, probably about a half of an avocado here, and they're perfectly ripe. I take this and I just do this in my hand, and I'll make a couple of quick scores with the tip of my knife. And hopefully you're being very careful here. Don't go through the skin if you can avoid it. And then I just push down. And I should be able to take a spoon and just scoop these right out into the bowl. Bingo. All right, so we've got most of the major components in there. I want to add cilantro. This is great cilantro from Coke Farms, absolutely delicious products. Coke Farms makes some of the best organic produce in America. They grow just some of the best berries I've ever had. And so I hope you can find Coke Farms stuff. Check them out online. But typically, back in the day, I would always cook with the cilantro leaf. And it was great chef that I worked for on Nantucket, Chef Seth Rayner, who taught me that the stem actually holds better flavor of cilantro than the leaves do. The leaves are also kind of wimpy. And so it's great for a ceviche to use the stems. They're gonna hold up a little bit better. They're not gonna go as wimpy or you don't run the risk of them turning black as much as you do with the leaves. And so I'm gonna slice these stems super thin. I'm gonna keep them in the band that I bought them in. I'll give them a quick rinse and then just come right across the stems. And about a couple of inches worth of stems should do the trick. So I get rid of any of the stragglers here. I always trim the very end. Those are gonna be the woodiest bits. Those go bye-bye into the garbage disposal and compost bin. And then just across the bunch here, nice and thin. Okay, I've got maybe a quarter cup of cilantro stems. These come right into the bowl. Okay, all cleaned up. Now look, if you're one of the folks that doesn't like cilantro because it tastes like soap, never fear, you have two options. You can omit it, or you can just keep eating more cilantro. Eventually you will overcome it. I know this firsthand. I used to hate cilantro, and now I can't get enough of it. And so just keep going, you'll be okay, I promise, no big deal. We're coming down to the last few components. I've got a couple of limes and my trusty microplane. Now I'm gonna use my microplane really quickly to get the zest off of these. The zest is the outer part of citrus that has all those essential oils, so it's gonna be a lot of lime flavor. If you use lemons, it would be a lot of lemon flavor, or orange, the same thing, a lot of orange flavor without any of the juice or sweetness or acid. I'm gonna also use the juice of this, but I'm gonna start by using the zest. We'll see if I wanna get one or two limes zest into this. It might just be one. I'm definitely gonna use the juice of two though. And here we go. Now, as I'm microplaning, I hold this in my hand and I just roll it gently across that microplane. Be careful, the microplane will bite you if you're not paying attention, but it's already so fragrant. You can see how bald I'm getting that by taking and using that rolling technique across the microplane. Okay, I did pretty good. That's a pretty bald lime, I'd say. And so, I think that's gonna be enough zest. If you want it more limey, add more lime. Before I get into juice, and I've got my microplane, I also am gonna microplane in one clove of raw garlic. I like that punch of garlic. You could add scallion to this, that would be great as well, both the white and the light green parts, but I'm gonna go garlic. All right, it's time for the juice. So make sure when you're juicing citrus, you cut it around the equator, not north to south. When you cut it around the equator, you get to see all the segments and you expose all of those little suprems that are gonna release all their juice. As opposed to, if you cut it north to south, I'll show you what that looks like, you only expose two of the segments. So cutting it across the equator rather than north to south is gonna yield you a more juicy lime. These are pretty juicy as it is. I didn't roll them or anything like that. You certainly can do that. It's an old bartender trick. I do get my handy dandy little citrus juicer. Great forearm workout. I've got nice big strong forearms. Those are pretty juicy limes. But again, this could be lemons, this could be grapefruit, could be orange if you want. You need a little bit of acid in there, especially if you're gonna go ceviche style. So pick your citrus of choice. All right, a quick stir. We gotta have some salt. Good pinch of kosher in there. Okay. I'm gonna add a little bit of extra virgin olive oil just to provide some fat. You could use a virgin olive oil or some other type of oil that you enjoy. I would avoid truffle oil now and forever. Stop using truffle oil, it's disgusting. Okay, quick toss. Oh, that looks so good. Now, again, if you don't have jalapeno or if you want it even spicier, you could add sriracha, you could add some Calabrian chili paste, you could add chili flake to this, that would all be great. Same thing, roasted red peppers, you could get all kinds of fun things in here. Cucumber if you wanted to, you know how I love cucumber, I know some of you hate it out there, I've gotten the messages, this is gonna be so yummy. I'm only gonna let this sit about 5 or 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna chow down. One quick taste to make sure my seasoning's on point. Okay, we'll see you in 5 minutes. All right, it's been 5 or 6 minutes. I'm gonna plate this up, here we go. Scallops, they just look so amazing. Now, especially where they've only marinated for a few minutes, they're just gonna keep some of that kind of transparency. The longer they sit in the acid, the more opaque they'll go as they chemically cook. And so, that's gonna be a good little lunch portion for me. Oh, I have enough to share or to have for dinner. I wish you were here, don't you? Some blue tortilla chips. This is gonna be perfect. Sitting out on the patio, enjoying the nice day. Gosh, I love scallops. Those are so delicious. This is gonna make a great lunch or a great appetizer at your next dinner party. I hope you enjoyed watching our episode today. And again, this technique can be applied across any type of fish. I would suggest whitefish or even salmon would work great with this. I would avoid things that are very, very lean or big game fish like tuna or swordfish marinating it like this. You certainly could use all the components and make them on their own and then just dress some slices of raw tuna. But I don't know if I would marinate it like this. But with the scallops, it's absolutely perfect. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's episode. I hope you make this at home. If you enjoyed, share it with your friends. Hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. We'll see you next time on Fill in the Food. Okay, last but not least, a good drizzle of olive oil. This is extra virgin. You could use regular virgin. You could use the kind of slutty olive oil if you wanted to. Am I allowed to say that? Slutty olive oil? I mean, it's just a joke about virgin olive oil. Should we shoot it?